Hi, this is Bruce Kaufman. Thanks for taking time to watch this short video. It's one of several videos that I'm doing to demonstrate the various Excel projects I've done for clients over the years. In this case, I'm going to show you a cash flow projection model that I did for a company that was a refining company. It has some interesting little features in it, so let me just get started and just tell you something about the project first. The client was a refining company that wanted to buy a fractionation barge, which they were going to put in a river in Nigeria. And the purchase was supposed to be guaranteed by the Export-Import Bank. I was called in because part of the application process was a cash flow projection needed to be included in the documents. Some of the features of this particular application are, as I have a summary page right at the front, the process of producing the product was rather straightforward, but the flow of funds was kind of complex, and I wanted the user and the viewer of the model to understand how the money was flowing when they saw the cash flow. It also took volumes of gas that were initially condensate in a gas stream and converted them into gallons of liquid to which we could assign a price to determine what the revenue stream would be in dollars from that particular flow of gas that was coming from the provider. And also, there are several places where the user can vary the components for basis of estimating not only composition of the gas stream, but also market prices. So with all that said, let's just go ahead and take a look at the take a quick look at the model. Okay, so here we are. This is just the front page of the model. Here is the highlight page that shows the flow. Basically, these items that I'm clicking on right here is the production process. All these arrows, though, that you see with the dollars reflect how the money was going to flow. Basically, because this was in Nigeria with a Nigerian company, there was essentially a lockbox arrangement. So somebody could look at this and get a better understanding of how the cash flowed. On this highlight page, this was really a summary of all the data that follows, so people could get a quick overview of the project. Basically, what determined the revenues were the volume of condensates that could be refined coming out of the gas stream. And we estimated a best, worst, and normal case, rich being the best case with the highest level of condensates, expected being the normal, and lean being the lowest. And basically, the user could vary what the daily volume was and these other factors that you see in blue. All right, and everything else that's in black was calculated as you change this. And what this did was not only showed you, if you'll look over in this section, as I change this, you'll see that those numbers change. Also, the net present value and the internal rate of return changed as well. Okay, that's the summary page. On this page, the user, this is for the user, so they could actually define what made up each of these individual streams. In other words, a lean stream, what are the components in a lean stream versus what are the components in a rich? And you can see in this column, the various components are higher than they are over here. And then this, of course, would affect the total revenues. But this is totally user-driven. This is just some basic gas properties that were needed in calculation, so we put this in here. This page is one of the keystones of the workbook. This basically takes you from the start, and I've got a table for each stream, but basically takes you from the start of the components that are in the gas stream, and then based on their gas properties, as you go across, it goes through the process of converting the volume of gas into a gallon of product. And then we have values right here, and this comes from another table I'm going to show you, so that based on the expectations of the stream, we can then generate an expected dollar volume, total dollars per item that's going to be produced. Just some basic information on operating expenses that are driven by information put in elsewhere, amortization table of the loan, depreciation expense, something that summarizes basically the net present value and internal rate of return. This is where the gas prices come from. This basically, the user can go in here and set the prices of the various components, and then that is what gets fed into This page right here. That's where these numbers come from. Okay. This is just some basic information that is coming straight from the contract in terms of affecting the total cash flow. This is just the blank template. There was no historical information, but if they wanted to use this for the future, we went ahead and left this in. It's a blank template, so some of the areas are going to be blank, but then all these numbers feed into forecast income statement, and on this page the user could put in the various expected dollar for these various items to operate the plant while it was on location. We have a forecast balance sheet, forecast cash flow ratios, and so forth. So that's a quick summary of this model that we did. Again, the key part being that we put in this highlight of the transaction sequence, and we had this table where we can convert from a gas component to a barrel of liquid. Thanks for taking a look.